सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां। The seventh chapter of Panchadashi is known as Trupti Dripa Prakaranam. Prakaranam means section or chapter. Dipa means a lamp. A lamp is something that which illumines an object. A lamp is a lamp that which illumines something. Here, this seventh chapter of this Panchadashi Grantha serves like a lamp, and it is going to illumine something. Illumine means a lamp is that which makes the object in front evident. A lamp or light which makes an object which is in front as an evident object. Similarly, this Panchadashi, seventh chapter, is like a lamp. It has to serve like a light. It illumines what? Trupti. Trupti means here contentment. The literal meaning of Trupti is contentment, fulfillment. This seventh chapter explains or shows light upon. This seventh chapter shows light upon or explains on Trupti. Therefore, this chapter is known as Trupti Deepa Prakaranam. Prakaranam means section or chapter. Deepa means light. Light is that which illumines something. Here, this Deepa, the light, here is illumining the Trupti. Trupti means fulfillment. Fulfillment means moksha. Trupti is equal to fulfillment. Fulfillment is equal to moksha. So this seventh chapter, Vidyaranya, is going to explain, show light upon Trupti or moksha. Moksha can be defined in two ways. Moksha can be defined, or Trupti can be defined in two ways. One way is positive way of presentation. Another way is negative way of presentation. Positive way, if you present what is moksha, positive way if you want to say, sukha praptihi eva mokshaha. Sukha praptihi or ananda praptihi, attainment of ananda, is called mokshaha. In the negative way, if you want to present moksha, dukkha nivrittihi, freedom from sorrow, is called mokshaha. Freedom from sorrow. Attainment of ananda is called mokshaha or sukha praptihi. Dukkha nivrittihi. Dukkha nivrittihi, freedom from sorrow. Negative way if you present. So both put together, sukha prapti rupa dukkha nivritti rupa mokshaha. Moksha is nothing but sukha prapti dukkha nivritti. Or dukkha nivritti sukha prapti. If you want to put in Tamil, kurai ondrum illai. தட் இஸ் குறை ஒன்றும் இல்லை என்னது நெகட்டிவ் வே ஆஃப் பிரசன்டேஷன். துக்கம் ஒன்றும் இல்லை என்ன, துக்க நிவத்திகி, சுகப்பிராப்திகி, நிறைவு, நிறைவு பூரி, லைக் யூனோ பூரி ஆஃப்டர் பிகமிங் ஃபுல் இட் ஸ்டாப்ஸ் மூவிங். தட்ஸ் வை இட் இஸ் கால்ட் பூர்ணம். வென் இட் பிகம்ஸ் பூர்ணம் இட் ஸ்டாப்ஸ் மூவிங். பூரி இஸ் த ஷார்ட் ஃபார்ம் ஆஃப் பூர்ணம். சுவாமிஜி சேஸ் பூரி இஸ் த ஷார்ட் ஃபார்ம் ஆஃப் பூர்ணம். தேர்ஃபோர் நிறைவு மீன்ஸ் பூர்ணா அஹம் பிரம்மா அஸ்மி. திஸ் நாலெட்ஜ் இஸ் கால்ட் மோக்ஷா. தட் இஸ் நோன் ஆஸ் திருப்தி. துக்க நிவத்தி சுக பிராப்தி ஈஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு திருப்தி, ஈஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு மோக்ஷா. தட் இஸ் த சப்ஜெக்ட் மேட்டர் ஆஃப் திஸ் செவன்த் சாப்டர். Therefore, this chapter is known as Tripti Deepa Prakaranam. This is the title description. Tripti Deepa Prakaranam. Tripti, only two letters. But how many slokas he has written? Vidyaranya, 298 verses. To talk about this Tripti, he borrows one mantra from Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, fourth chapter, fourth brahmanam, 12th mantra. He borrows that brahmanam is known as sharira brahmanam, sharirakam brahmanam, very important brahmanam. One mantra, there are so many mantras in that brahmanam. One mantra he takes, it is which is in one sloka form. That one mantra talks about that tripti or moksha. So Vidyaranya bodily lifts that sloka, writes here in the first sloka. So 298 slokas, one sloka is that mantra, first sloka is that mantra. Then 297 slokas he comments upon that one sloka. How great he is, you know. 297 slokas, or you can take second sloka is also introductory sloka. That means 297 slokas he elaborately explains on one sloka, that is 4.4.12 of Brihadaranyaka. How genius he is, and how much that mantra has got the content. That means he is putting a zoom lens upon one mantra. Zoom lens means how much zooming, this much zooming. So elaborately. Yes, there is a content in that to be grasped. What is that mantra? In the form of first shloka, this chapter begins. We will read. Atmanam chedvijaniyat. Ayam asmiti purushah. கிமிச்சன் கஸ்ய காமாய ஶரீர மனு சஞ்ஜ்வரேத். This is the sloka borrowed from Brihadaranyaka Upanishad. Total mantra he has bodily lifted from Brihadaranyaka. No change, even a single word. So the whole mantra, just he has cut and paste. Cut and paste na no problem. If you cut and paste and there, you won't get again that sloka. But in Brihadaranyaka, this mantra is available. Those who are doing cut and paste only knows this problem. So once you do cut and paste it, in previous place you won't get it. But here he did cut and paste. It is olden days cut and paste. That it is available in Brihadaranyaka all the time. Okay, now I'll give you the gist of this shloka, the meaning we have to see. I am very happy some students are here, at least those who have attended Brihadaranyaka Upanishad long, long ago. Those who have attended this Brahmanam, you can recollect and go home, see your notes if you have, and check. It's very, very important mantra. Purushaha. Purushaha is a chandasa prayogaha. Purushaha eva purushaha. Here, purushaha means not a male, but a person. Sadhana chatushtaya sampannaha. Jivaha. Sadhakaha. Purushaha. Atmanam vijaniyat chet. Atmanam means oneself, his own self. Vijaniyat chet. Vijaniyat, one should know one's nature, one's self. One should know. Vijaniyat is sambhavanayam vidhilingana. Vijaniyat, one should know one's Atman nature. Chet, if one knows, is there. One should know, Vidhiling is telling. Suppose it happens, if he knows. Shankaracharya writes there in Brihadaranyaka Bhashyam for this Chet. Why Upanishad using the Chet? It is rarely happens. People working, attending Panchadashi class or attending Brihadaranyaka Upanishad class and studying, recognizing, claiming that I am Brahman, rarely happens. That is why mantra also, Chet, if anyone comes and attend the class and listen from the Guru and get the knowledge and own up the Atma Swarupam, if it happens, one should know the Atman nature as what? Now the important point. Paramatmanam, Atmanam means the self, as the Paramatmanam, I am this Atma, that means Paramatma. Atmanam means oneself. The Paramatmanam. Paramatmanam, I am. I am means this. Ahamasmi iti. I am is there. Vijaniyadayam. After I am, you have to supply aham also. I am ahamasmi iti. I am aham asmi within inverted commas. I am ahamasmi iti. I am Brahman. I am tatpada lakshyartha rupa Brahman. Ahamasmi tvampada lakshyartha rupa aham asmi. Ahamasmi iti. Inverted commas close. I am ahamasmi iti. Vijaniyat chet. I am that Brahman. Aham Brahmasmi. One should know. Then this is called Jnanam. So first line is talking about Atma Jnanam. Upanishad is telling every human being should know his or her own Atma Swarupam. Every human being should know his or her own ఆత్మస్వరూపం యాజ్ వన్ సెల్ఫ్. పరమాత్మ ది టోటల్ బ్రహ్మన్ అండ్ ఐ ది ఆత్మా ఐఎమ్ వన్ అండ్ ద సేమ్. అహమస్మి ఇతి. దెన్ సెకండ్ లైన్ మంత్ర గివ్స్ జ్ఞాన ఫలం. ఇఫ్ వన్ నోస్ దిస్, attains this knowledge, what is the phalam? What is the benefit? The benefit is this. Sarva kama nivrittihi is the benefit. Sarva kama nivrittihi. Here, I am ahamasmi, one more point we have to note. I am means the turiya atma. నాంతః ప్రజ్ఞం న బహిష్ప్రజ్ఞం, సెవెంత్ మంత్ర ఆఫ్ మాండుక్య. శాంతం శివమద్వైతం చతుర్థం మన్యంతే స ఆత్మా స విజ్ఞేయ. దట్ తురీయ ఆత్మా, దట్ విజ్ఞేయ, బృహదారణ్య సేస్ విజానీయాత్. జ్ఞాధాతు బోత్. దేర్ఫోర్ అహం, ఐ యామ్, ఐ టు బి సప్లైడ్, asmi, I am, the turiya atma. The benefit is this. Jnani gets total trupti. Jnani gets total trupti. Upanishad presents in a unique manner. Jnani attains total trupti when he attains this knowledge. Jnani attains a total fulfillment when he attains this knowledge. Instead of saying total fulfillment, kama nivritti, Upanishads putting indirectly. Instead of saying directly, he will not, he attains fulfillment, that is direct way of presentation. Upanishad puts indirectly phalam. What is that? Kim icchan kasya kamaya shariram anusanjvaret. We can make this sentence into three portions. Kim icchan, one portion. Kasya kamaya, another portion. Shariram anusanjvaret. Kimichan means desiring what? A jnani, after knowing his real nature or her real nature, what will he desire or what will she desire? What will she desire or he desires? There is no desiring person, there is no desiring object. Desired object is not there to desire, because the desirer is also not there. Desirer is called subject. Desired object, any object, experienced object, represents bhogya prapancha. Desired person, desiring person is called subject, bhokta. Desired object is known as bhogya vastu. Once this jnani attains brahma jnanam, falsified his ahankara, there is no subject, the desirer is not there. Kasya kamaya represents bhokta nishedhaha, bhoktrutva nishedhaha, subject nishedhaha. Who is the beneficiary? To enjoy something, suppose I feel hungry only, food is relevant. If I feel hungry, only food is relevant. Food is there, but nobody is there to eat. What is the use of food? Food is food when somebody is there to desire to eat. Hunger is fulfilled. Hunger can be appeased only when there is food. So, hungry person and food, both are required. Bhogya padartha ahara. Bhokta, the eater, hungry person. These two are there only. Food is meaningful, hunger also meaningful. Hunger is there, food is not there. But food is there, hunger is not there. What is the use? Hunger is there for a hungry person. Food is not there. What is use? He cannot get any benefit. Food is there, but there is no hungry person. What is the use of this food? No use. So, two are required. Subject, hungry person. Food, the object. Both are required. Desired object, food. Desiring person, hungry person, both are required. Isn't it? So, bhogya padartha aharaha, bhokta the eater, hungry person, both are required when the one action has to happen, the desire has to be fulfilled. Kama praptihi, that fulfillment when comes, when I eat food, appa, hunger gone. Like that, here for a jnani, the subject, no? Suppose a person, Krishnashtami day, murukku cheeda illa, they prepare. Or tata irukkar avunna veetla, yaarume illa. 90 year old tata, no pallu, ange poi murukku cheeda panna na enna prayojanam na. இன்னும் முறுக்கு சீடை பிரயோஜனமே கிடையாது. அதனால் ஒரு ஆப்ஜெக்ட் இருக்கணும். த பர்சன் டு என்ஜாய் தட் ஆப்ஜெக்ட் ஆல்சோ மஸ்ட் பி தேர். அதர்வைஸ் தெர் இஸ் நோ யூஸ் ஆஃப் தட் ஆப்ஜெக்ட் ஆர் சப்ஜெக்ட். இஸ்இன்ட் இட்? நவ் ஹியர் ஜ்ஞானி, பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் ஜ்ஞானம், சர்வ காம அவாப்தி, ஹி ஹேஸ் காட் த ஃபுல்ஃபில்மெண்ட். No desirer is there, ahankara is falsified, desirer has gone, desired object, worldly bhogya prapancha is also falsified. Kasya kamaya, for whose benefit sake he has to desire, because ahankara falsified. Kimichan, desiring what? What can he desire in this world, any object? Every object is falsified in the world. No object is satyam. Every object is false, mithya. Nama, rupa, prapancha, mithya. There is no satta in this world. There is no any quality in this world. What he can desire, for whose benefit? What he or she can desire, for whose benefit? Kimichan kasya kamaya. That is the meaning. Kimichan, what object of desire, what object of desire is there to desire? What object of desire is there to desire? Bhogya prapancha nishedhaha. Kimichan is bhogya prapancha nishedhaha. Kasya kamaya, for the benefit of which bhokta? Kasya kamaya means for the benefit of which bhokta? The Upanishad negating the desiring ahankara, desiring person. Desiring ahankara or desiring person, Upanishad is negating, because in that jnani, ahankara is falsified. Bhokta is falsified. Bhogya prapancha is falsified. Kimichan kasya kamaya. Then what? Sarira manusanjvaret. Sarira manusanjvaret means here, Jwaram means jwaram. Sarira jwaram. Anusanjwaram means which jnani will struggle along with body. An artha. which Jnani will struggle for body, which body is struggling. Body is struggling, tension, anxiety, stress, so much of jwaram. Anujwaram means going along with anujwaram. That is called anujwaram. Anusanjwaram, feverish, and the English la. Jwaram anna feverish. Restlessness or anxiety. Since he has got contentment, tripti, moksha, ananda is there, what he can desire? Is there anything to desire? For whose benefit he can desire? Subject out, object out, who will desire, what he will desire. Therefore, there is no need of anujwaram. He need not go along with this body. Sharira means shrinati. Shiryamanam shariram. Shiryamanam swabhavam shariram. 9p, 9th conjugation. Ichan ish dhatu takarantaha pumlingaha. Ichat ish dhatu. Ichan, desiring what? Here kamaya means prayojanaya anartham. For whose benefit? Prayojanaya kamaya. Kasya prayojanaya tadarthe chaturthi. Why should jnani struggle for them, for pleasures? Because there is no desirer, there is no desired object also. According to him, according to jnani, everything is mithya. So akshepaarthe kimichchan natu prashnaarthe. Akshepaarthe, nothing is there to desire for him, because he is not going to be a beneficiary. Therefore, akshepaarthe natu prashnaarthe. Yat yad hi kurute karma tat tat hi kamasya cheshtitam. Whenever a person does any action, it is propelled by kama only, desire only. Any action, whenever a person does for fulfillment sake, it is because of kama. Jnani also does certain actions, but not fulfillment, not for purnatvam. That is why jnani desires are not binding desires. If they are fulfilled, okay, not fulfilled also okay, but he is not, or she is not doing for fulfillment. Any actions, they are not doing for fulfillment. They are doing out of fulfillment. Jnani does actions out of fulfillment, not for fulfillment. Jnani does actions, but not for fulfillment, but out of fulfillment. Yad yad hi kurute karma. Jnani, whatever action he or she does, yad yad hi kurute karma, tat tat hi kamasya cheshtitam. Tat tat kamasya cheshtitam. Kamathinaladhan ella pandra. That is why anujwaram. People are having a lot of tension, anxiety, going here and there, along with body they run. The desire, you know, drags the person, the body. Deepavali has come. Now you see how rush Chennai. You know, people are going, buying Deepavali sale. Yen adha. Yastu atmaratirevasyat atmatruptascha manavaha atmanyevacha santushtaha tasya karyam na vidyate. Nothing is there for him to do. Karyam na vidyate. Tasya karyam here, jwaram na vidyate ityartha. Karyam here, jwaram ityartha. All people are running, running here and there to get some fulfillment. It is called a jwaram. அக்கார்டிங் டு உபனிஷத்து. நான் சொல்லலை, எல்லாம் ரன்னிங்கோ ரன்னிங்னு எல்லாரும் பண்ணுறான் இல்லையோ, இதெல்லாம் என்ன உபனிஷத்து சொல்கிறது? அவங்களுக்கு எல்லாம் ஜுரம் ஒன்று, அவங்களுக்கு எல்லாம் ஒரு ஜுரம் ஒன்று, ஃபீவரிஷ். தட்ஸ் வை தே ஆர் ரன்னிங் ஹியர் அண்ட் தேர் பிஹைண்ட் ஆப்ஜெக்ட்ஸ். தேர்ஃபோர் கிமிச்சன் இஸ் கால்ட் போக்ய நிஷேதா, கிம் கஸ்ய காமாய இஸ் போக்தா நிஷேதா, சரீரம் அனுசஞ்சரேத் கர்ம நிஷேதா அன்னார். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் த மீனிங் ஆஃப் தி ஸ்லோகா, ஸ்லோகா ஆஃப் பிருஹதாரண்யகா 4.4.12, that is given in the footnote here in the paragraph. They have given that number. Next shloka we will read. Asya shrute rabhi prayah, samyagatra vicharyate, ஜீவன் முக்தஸ்ய யா த்ருப்திஹி, ஸா தேன விஷதாயதே. சரீரம் அனுசஞ்சரேத் மீன்ஸ் சஃபரிங் அலாங் வித் த பாடி என் அர்த்தம். There is no suffering along with the body to this jnani. Even though the prarabdha is exhausting in this body, jnani never have that effect of that prarabdha. Jnani doesn't have the effect of that prarabdha. Now in this ஸ்லோக்க வித்யாரண்யர் ஸ்டார்ட்ஸ் ஹிஸ் வே ஆஃப் எக்ஸ்பிளனேஷன் ஃப்ரம் திஸ் ஸ்லோக ஆன்வர்ட்ஸ். அத்ர, அத்ர மீன்ஸ் இன் திஸ் 4.4.12 ஆஃப் பிருஹதாரண்யக, அஸ்யாஹ ஸ்ருதேஹே அபிப்ராயஹ, கண்டிங்ஷன் அபிப்ராயஹ மீன்ஸ் அபி ப்ளஸ் ப்ரா ப்ளஸ் இ தாது அபிப்ராயஹ. உபனிஷத் சஜெஸ்ட், ஸ்ருதி சஜெஸ்ட் அபிப்ராயஹ. உபனிஷத் ஹாவ் அன் ஒப்பீனியன், ஸ்ருதேஹே அபிப்ராயஹ. த அபோவ் செட் ஸ்லோகா இஸ் த ஒப்பீனியன் ஆஃப் த உபனிஷத். ஹூ சேஸ்? வித்யாரண்ய சேஸ் அபிப்ராயஹ. கஸ்ய அஸ்யாஹ ஸ்ருதேஹே, திஸ் பிருஹதாரண்யக உபனிஷத் 4.4.12 அபோவ் செட் மந்த்ரா உபனிஷத் அபிப்ராயம் ஒப்பீனியன் ஆர் சஜஷன் சம்யக் விசாரியதே. ஐ ஆம் கோயிங் டு எலாபரேட்லி டு அனாலிசிஸ். விசாரியதே மீன்ஸ் அனாலிசிஸ். சம்யக் கிளியர்லி I am going to do the analysis. By the analysis of this 4.4.12, very clearly I am going to do that analysis. Full import ityarthaha. Abhiprayaha means whole teaching. Whole teaching I am going to give in this chapter. I am going to analyze the mantra's whole teaching given by the Upanishad. I am going to clearly explain. Samyagana, evala samyagana 296 slokas, only 296. Ipo vitta edum innu eludruvar avaru. What is that I am writing? Ya truptihi jivan muktasya, the trupti talked about. Tripti means the contentment. Kama nivrittihi, freedom from all desires. No desirer, no desired object. But what is their tripti then? Adada tripti. Real tripti. Fulfillment, contentment. In spite of everything available. In spite of everything available, nobody is there to see also if he or she can enjoy thoroughly. Let me enjoy, nobody is there to see. But desire illa enna pandrathu? There is no desire to enjoy. Either secretly or publicly, openly. Interest, desirer should be there to desire. Desired object edavad irukkanume, rendume illana eppadi enna enjoy pandrathu? So ahankara is false. Desirer is not coming in from out, inside. Desired object irukana inga desirer illana desired object irund enna prayojanam? Adhavadi mithya. Therefore, Jnani is one for whom apta kamaha. So if we listen for worldly people, paavam avarku ennamo aachi ani nenapponamo. Really people take like that. It is something wrong, psychologically wrong, they say like that. There is a book written by one foreigner. They have did lot of research. Research means they have taken interview in the whole Himalayas. They went, they interviewed so many saints, sadhus, and so many mahatmas, personally interviewed. And after interviewing everything, they have written a book. The most sane, healthy person in the world is a sadhu, a saint, a mahatma, a jnani. All are synonyms. Saint vere, sadhu vere, mahatma vere, chellakudadu. Nammakella thani thani kediyadu. The one who is saint is a sadhu. Who is a sadhu is a jnani. Who is a jnani is a sthitapragnaha, gunatitaha, parabhaktaha. A jnani is one who is free from all desires, is the sane and healthiest person, psychologically sane. They have written there. All other people are insane, mentally sick, wanting person. They are always wanting person. A person who is complete, purnaha, anandaha, truptaha, nothing is required for him, remains as it is. So, jivan muktasya ya truptihi, sa tena vishadayate, sa truptihi, that truptihi which Upanishad talked about jivan mukta, the contentment, trupti is called mukti. Mukti is called trupti. Mukti vere, trupti vere ille. Dhatus are different. Trippu dhatu, muchu dhatu. But wherever there is trupti, there is mukti. Wherever mukti is there, there is trupti. Podum endra manam? Aha. Adella, ninga sonnadhu ella kaadhula kekkaattalum kuda enakku inimaiya irukum. Ennumo sound vandhadhu. நம்ம பெரியவங்களெல்லாம் சொல்லி வச்சிருக்கான், ஆனாலும் வச்சிருக்கான், நமக்கு உள்ள போகணுமே. ஜீவன் முக்தஸ்யா திருப்தி, சா தட் திருப்தி, தேன, தேன மீன்ஸ் பை திஸ் டீச்சிங், தேன தி கண்டென்ட்மெண்ட் ஆஃப் சச் ஏ ஜீவன் முக்தா, தேன விஷதாயதே பை தி analysis of this, by the analysis of this 4412, tena vishadayate will become clear. Vishadayate means it will become clear that jivan muktasya truptihi, by my analysis, by my explanation of this chapter, samyak vicharyate, I am going to do elaborate analysis. By my analysis, what am I going to do, you know? That jivan muktasya trupti ho nirikilyo, adi nalla ungalukku ella clear ah theriyum ani solrar. Sa vishadayate, vishadam na clear. Vishadayate, a verb which is a denominative verb it is. Noun, when it is a verb which is taken as a noun, it is called denominative verb. Namadhatu vishadayate will become clear. Next shloka. Shruti abhiprayaha, it's like a dhvani. No, it is a dhvani. Shruti is there. And after listening the Shruti Shabda, the sound will ring, 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 ring in our ears. அது ரிங் ரிங் ஆகிறது இல்லை தெரியல எனக்கு உங்களுக்கு எனக்கு ரிங் ஆகிறது ரிங்கிங் ரிங்கிங் அந்த ஸ்ருதி சப்தம் மஸ்ட் ரிங் இன் அவர் இயர்ஸ் ஆல் த டைம் மகா வாக்கியாஸ் தென் ஓன்லி இட் ஒர்க்ஸ் தட் இஸ் கால்டு துவனி தட் இஸ் கால்டு துவனி திஸ் ஹோல் ஒன் மந்த்ரா இஸ் லைக் ஸ்ருதி My 297 slokas are like dhvani. The sound is going to ring in your ears. Of what? And the first shloka. 4412 of Brihadaranyaka of my first shloka is going to ring in your ears like a dhvani. That it has to be, no? Like a bell, you know? Like a bell, and ஒரு வாட்டி அடித்த அந்த ரிங் 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 சவுண்ட் கண்டினியூ ஆகிண்டே இருக்கும் இல்லையா அது மாதிரி ரிங் ஆகணும் தட் ஈஸ் த மீனிங் ஹியர் ஸ்ருதி துவனி அபிப்பிராய நதா ஸ்ருதி அபிப்பிராய ஷுட் ரிங் இன் அவர் இயர்ஸ் டு பிகம் தட் கிளாரிட்டி இஃப் யூ கெட் இட் மோர் அண்ட் மோர் It rings like a bell in your ears. இதெல்லாம் சும்மா எக்ஸாஜரேஷன் ஐ எம் டெல்லிங் எக்ஸாஜரேஷன் என்னென்னா ஒரு ஸ்லோக்காக்கு 290 ஸ்லோக்காஸ் ஹூ வில் ரைட் ஹூ வில் ரைட் அன்லெஸ் ஹி ஹேஸ் காட் சோ மச் இன் ஹிஸ் மைண்ட் ஹீ இஸ் கோயிங் டு ப்ரெசன்ட் இன் ஸ்டேஜஸ் சப்த செவன் ஸ்டேஜஸ் ஹீ இஸ் கோயிங் டு ப்ரெசன்ட் த ஹோல் டீச்சிங் அந்த செவன் ஸ்டேஜஸ்க்கு ஒரு ஒரு ஸ்டேஜ் எலாபரேஷன் நெக்ஸ்ட் ஸ்லோக தேர்ட் ஸ்லோக மாயாபாசேன ஜீவேஷௌ கரோதீதி ஸ்ருதத்வதஹ கல்பிதாவேவ ஜீவேஷௌ தாப்யாம் சர்வம் ப்ரகல்பிதம் Now, from third verse onwards up to 28th shloka, the textual commentary, first level of teaching or first level of commentary upon 4412. In the 4412 up to last you have to remember. Until this chapter you have to remember 4412. You can never forget. Now, he says, previous shloka, sa means that contentment of jnani or jivan muktaha. I am going to explain. Now, first word he is taking purushaha. Purushaha word is there in the mantra. Now he is taking that word. அந்த மந்திரத்தில் இருக்கிற ஒரு ஒரு வேர்டு எடுத்துட்டு ஹி இஸ் கோயிங் டு எக்ஸ்பிளைன் இந்த பூருஷா இஸ் ஜீவா த இண்டிவிஜுவல் த இண்டிவிஜுவல் ஹியூமன் பீயிங் சாதன சதுஷ்டய சம்பன்னா ஷுட் நோ தி ஆத்மஸ்வரூபம் சொன்னார் ஹூ இஸ் திஸ் சாதன சதுஷ்டய சம்பன்னா ஹூ இஸ் திஸ் பர்சன் Who is this jiva? He want to say. That is the meaning he is going to explain. The jivaha is maya bhasena jiveshau maya jiveshau karoti iti abhasena. That abhasena come later. Maya. Where from this jiva has come, first of all? Upanishad telling, one, the sadhana chatushtaya sampannaha, the jivaha should know the Atman. Who is this person, first of all? Who should know? That person, first of all, created by whom? Maya. Maya Devi, she does two jobs. What should? She is the cause for that providing, reflecting mediums. A kutastha chaitanyam. Chaitanyam is chaitanyam, Brahman. To reflect for kutastha Brahman, chaitanyam, this maya provide two reflecting mediums. At one micro level, you know, antahkaranam. Macro level, maya is another medium. Once it provides, jiva ishav karoti. Once this atma chaitanyam, brahma chaitanyam, one chaitanyam. Once two mediums are provided, this atma chaitanyam provided by maya. And this atma chaitanyam, once the mediums are provided, it reflects the micro and macro mediums. Micro medium antahkaranam, once the chaitanyam reflects in that micro medium antahkaranam is called jivaha. Micro RC is called jivaha. And macro RC, the reflected consciousness in maya medium, is called Ishvaraha. So, maya jiveshav karoti. Shrutatvataha, how do we know? Through Shastra we know. In the previous chapter we have studied already. So, karoti shrutatvataha. We have heard from the Shruti. Jiva ishav, jiveshav, kalpitav eva. This jivatvam and ishvaratvam both are only superimposed. Kalpitav eva, reflected consciousness, reflection. The jiva is reflection. Ishvara is also a reflection. Reflection of what? Reflection of Chaitanyam. Reflection of Chaitanyam Brahma. So, reflection in where? Jiva means antakkaranal reflection. Ishvara means maya oda reflection. In the maya alone provide this antakkaranam also. Adhanaala antakkaranam mayasthaha pradibimba chaitanyam. Antakkaranastha pradibimba chaitanyam jivaha, mayastha pradibimba chaitanyam ishvaraha. So now pradibimba chaitanyam, innoru vaati solli thirupi poyyani sollaponam, adu sollanum. Antakkaranastha pratibimba chaitanyam. Pratibimba chaitanyam satyama, is real or unreal? Unreal. Reflection is unreal. Isn't it? Pratibimba means what? Reflection. Your face in the mirror is reflection. Reflected face. Is it real or unreal? Unreal. Similarly, here Chaitanyam reflecting in the antakkaranam at micro level, macro level, maya, it is reflecting. Both are reflections. One is jiva reflect. Jiva, another is Ishvara. Both are reflections only. Are they real or unreal? That's what he says. Kalpitau eva. Kalpitau eva. They are, by creating two types of reflected consciousnesses. Abhasena. And the first line is abhasena. By creating two types of reflected consciousnesses, jiveshav karoti maya. Maya karoti. தட் மீன்ஸ் மாயா கிரியேட்ஸ் ஈஸ்வரா, அப்படிதான் தோன்றது இல்லையா? மாயா கிரியேட்ஸ் ஈஸ்வரான்னு அண்ணனோ, ஈஸ்வரா இஸ் அனாதி பிகினிங்லெஸ், மாயா இஸ் அனாதி பிகினிங்லெஸ், ஜீவாலுசோ அனாதி பிகினிங்லெஸ். தென் கிரியேட் கரோதி கிரியேட்டுன்னு சொன்னாள், மேனிஃபெஸ்ட் உபலப்தி, தட்ஸ் வாட் ஹீஸ் கோயிங் டு எக்ஸ்பிளைன். Creating means what? How this reflected consciousness is formed. That explanation comes later. Next shloka he gives. Shrutat kalpitau eva kalpitaveva jiveshau. Full stop. Tabhyam sarvam prakalpitam. Once the maya provides two mediums and reflections are formed, micro and macro, vyashti jiva, வியஷ்டி சமஷ்டி ஈஸ்வரா, போத்தார் வியாவகாரிக்கம், போத்தார் வியாவகாரிக்கம். பிரம்ம சைத்தன்யம் ஓன்லி ஒன் பாரமார்த்திகம், ஒன் ஓசி பாரமார்த்திகம், டூ ஆர்சி வியாவகாரிக்கம். டூ ஆர்சி வியாவகாரிக்கம் எட்டு, வெஷ்டி லெவல் ஒன் ஜீவா, சமஷ்டி லெவல் ஈஸ்வரா. தேர்ஃபோர் வெஷ்டி சமஷ்டி வியாவகாரிகா ஜீவ ஈஸ்வர பிரதிபிம்ப சைத்தன்யம் சார் கல்பிதம், மீன்ஸ் அன்ரியல். நெக்ஸ்ட் ஸ்லோக, ஈக்ஷணாதி பிரவேசாந்த சிருஷ்டிரீஷேன கல்பிதா. ஜாக்ரதாதி விமோக்ஷாந்தஹ சம்சாரோ ஜீவ கல்பிதஹ. இந்த அபோவ் செட் ஸ்லோகா தாப்யாம் சர்வ பிரகல்பிதம் சொன்னார். தாப்யாம் மீன்ஸ் வித் தட் ஜீவா அண்ட் ஈஸ்வரா, ஒன்ஸ் மாயா ஜாப் இஸ் ஓவர் providing mediums, two mediums have come, Jiva and Ishvara has come. Then Ishvara and Jiva start doing the creation. How? Next shloka idida. Ishchanadi praveshanta. What Ishvara does first? Ishvara vandachi, Jeevan vandita. Ishvara enna pandraarna first line la solraaru. Jeevan enna pannuva annu second line la solraaru. ஈக்ஷணாதி பிரவேசாந்த, ஈக்ஷண மீன்ஸ் விஷுவலைசேஷன். சோ காமயதா பஹுஸ்யாம் பிரஜா ஏயேதி சதபோ தப்யதா சதபஸ்தப்த்வா இதகும் சர்வம் அசிருஜத. சோ தட் ஈஸ்வரா என்டர்ஸ் ஈக்ஷணாதி பிரவேசாந்த. பிரவேசாந்த மீன்ஸ் அனுப்பிரவேச. சிருஷ்டி ஈஷேன கல்பிதா, ஈஸ்வரா கிரியேட் தி ஆப்ஜெக்டிவ் யூனிவர்ஸ். வி தி ஜீவாஸ் கிரியேட் வாட் சாரோ யூனிவர்ஸ். ஈஸ்வரா கிரியேட் தி ஆப்ஜெக்டிவ் யூனிவர்ஸ், ஜீவா கிரியேட் தி சப்ஜெக்டிவ் யூனிவர்ஸ். சப்ஜெக்டிவ் துக்கபூரித கன்வெர்டிங் தி ஆப்ஜெக்ட்ஸ் வாட் எவர் பகவான் ஹேஸ் கிரியேட்டட், அதில் கஷ்டமே பார்த்துட்டு இருக்கோம் இல்லையோ. ஸோ எவ்ரி ஆப்ஜெக்ட் ஈஸ் ஆல்வேஸ் கிவிங் பெயின் அண்ட் ப்ளஷர், பெயின் அண்ட் ப்ளஷர் ஆல் த டைம். திஸ் இஸ் ஜீவ சிருஷ்டி. ஓகே, ஜாகிரதாதி விமோக்ஷாந்தாக, திஸ் ஜீவா இஸ் ஃபேஸிங் ஜாகிரத அவஸ்தா, சொப்னாவஸ்தா, சுஷுப்தி அவஸ்தா. அதான் அவஸ்தை பட்டுன்னு இருக்கான், அவஸ்தலன்னு இருப்பான். அது வந்து ஜாகிரத் பிரபஞ்ச, he has not created avasthas. Bhagavan created only prapancha. Avasthas created by this jiva, that's why whole prapancha, there are two contributors. Ishvara is one contributor, jiva is one contributor. Ishvara is samanya karanam, jiva is vishesha karanam. His karma is the vishesha karanam. ஜீவனே இல்லைன்னா, அவன் கர்மா இல்லைன்னா, ஈஸ்வரன் ஹவு ஹீ கேன் கிரியேட், ஆன் வாட் பேஸ் ஹீ கேன் கிரியேட்? தேர்ஃபோர் ஈஸ்வரா இஸ் டிபெண்டிங் அப்பான் ஜீவா, ஜீவா ஆஃப்கோர்ஸ் டிபெண்டிங் அப்பான் ஈஸ்வரா. both of them are doing joint venture and starting what? Samsara anartham. Next class. Purnamada purnamidam purnat purnamudachyate purnasya purnamadaya purnameva vasishyate. Om shanti shanti shantih harih om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha harih om.